That nigga munch. Shall he eat for lunch?
Welcome back to the podcast. My name is Chris.
It's your boy, Ollie.
How's it going, man?
Yeah, I already know, man. Just bullying in the butt. How about you, bro?
Well, just eating the muffin. You know, hanging out. Have you ever had a muffin and a Gatorade?
That sounds slightly concerning.
Oh, it leaked all over me. Jesus.
Hey, well, pause, man. Don't ever say that again in your life, bro.
Why?
Shit, man.
I'm just hungry. We've been working all day.
Welcome to Ebonics with Ollie. Now, I got something real special for you guys today. What we're going to learn on this segment is something that you've never seen before. We're going to learn about words that appear in the Urban Dictionary. If you're African American, you're probably not going to need this. You can exit the video now. To everybody else, I'm going to teach you a new word today. M-U-N-C-H. Son of a bitch, I just broke my chalk. Ice Spice just dropped a new video. And in her song, she mentions these munches. Now, what a munch actually is a man who eats pussy with absolutely nothing in return. Do you want to be a munch? I don't.
We just shot a music video, and it took a while. And I didn't have anything today. It's 8:45 p.m.
You didn't eat breakfast?
Oh, no, I did have a breakfast burrito. Yeah, you're right.
Lying sack of shit. I'm sick of these fucking lies, man. Well, you know what's another lie that I've seen?
What?
DJ Vlad on Twitter.
Uh-huh.
I'm finna read this tweet out to you, man.
Who's DJ Vlad? Is he a DJ?
He's a Fed, man.
A Fed?
Yeah, he's a Fed, bro.
The federal government. I think I've heard of this guy.
Russian spy? Yes.
The porn star?
So here's what the tweet says.
Sorry.
He said, as an adult, playing video games for long periods of time is a form of depression. If you don't believe me, ask yourself this. Think about the 100 greatest moments of your life. Do any of these moments include video games? Probably not. And this comes from a lifetime gamer. Is that the sound of you clapping his cheeks?
I'm not into men. Although I wish I was.
Yeah, stop it, man.
Into men.
Not that there's anything wrong. Fuck you guys. I don't fucking care.
No, I don't know who DJ Vlad is. He sounds like a nice gentleman. He's from Russia and he's very introspective and you know, he, you know, was very vulnerable and decided to share the fact that he's gone through depression. He used to play video games. And, you know, quite frankly, I feel exactly the same way that he does. I've never played video games because I've always found better things to do with my time. Okay. But I will say this. Playing video games is the literal definition of living a lie. It's absolutely astonishing to me that humans willingly submerge themselves into a simulated reality. I mean, these people, they must hate themselves so much that they're willing to play video games for hours on end because their true existence lacks meaning.
I'm writing this down, by the way.
Okay, well, it lacks meaning and purpose. And it's a subculture for virgins. And incels. and it's really, really quite sad. That's all I have to say about that, just like Forrest Gump used to say. R.I.P. Forrest Gump.
I'm almost done, man.
Sure. What are you writing?
You're a director, correct?
I am a music video director, yes.
All right.
Sorry.
You enjoy films?
Well, occasionally, sure.
Check this out.
Okay.
Watching movies is for virgins and incels. It's the literal definition of a living lie.
Mm-hmm.
It's the first iteration of a simulation. These people hate themselves so much that they're willing to watch movies for hours on end because their true existence lacks meaning and purpose. Sad.
Well,
that's you.
I applaud you for quoting me. and for being such a great listener. And in fact, I think that you should probably be like a court recorder. You could be like typing all of the court conversations.
Yeah, they get paid pretty good, man. I'm not gonna lie.
Do they? Yeah, yeah. And I've heard they have life insurance and 401ks and pension plans and things of that nature. And that's all really great stuff to have if you're a person who likes to
that's
have
true.
A, you know, a nice and stable future. But
got that shit right now, man. I don't know if my future's stable.
No, but I don't really see a correlation between the video game fanatics and the film fanatics, because there's two very, very different fandoms, maybe we call them, different fan bases. I mean, video games, let's start with video games. So normally when people are fans of video games, you subscribe, you pay a monthly subscription, you mm-hmm. buy expensive video game consoles, you pay for very expensive video game, what are they called? Cartridges? They don't have those anymore. What are they called?
Cartridges?
Cartridges, yeah.
Bro, we're not playing N64 no more, bro.
That's the last time I played. I was a kid.
Chill out.
I was a kid. I don't know. I don't do those things anymore. It's like, anyhow, yeah, those things are very, very expensive, all those cartridges and the gaming consoles. And why do you keep laughing at me? Those are all very expensive things. And so what I'm trying to say is that not only are these people spending lots of money on their hobby, but on their lifestyle, really, we want to call it that. They spend multiple hours honing their skills at becoming better at playing these games. And
that's right.
They spend many hours contributing to the communities that they communicate with while they're, you know, wearing your headphones and
that's
the little
right.
microphones. And also on top of that, when they're not playing video games, what is that? Just think there's a crazy homeless man screaming outside.
He's just having a good time.
He's just, but anyway, when they're not playing video games, they're on YouTube watching other people play video games. To me, this sounds sick. It sounds sick. It sounds like a disease.
Nah.
Film
man.
Fanatics, myself included, I maybe devote maybe 2, 3, max 4 hours a month to watching films. And the rest of my time, it's allotted to actually filming people, like music videos and editing them and things of
that's
that nature.
Right. Right.
You know, I barely watch movies and I love them, but I just don't have time for it, you know?
Hey, but not everybody's like that, man. Everybody got a show they like to watch. Everybody's watching something on Netflix every night while they're eating, you know? And what he said was that people with depression play video games. I don't think that's true. It's more often that people want to escape reality and try and cure their depression by playing video games.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
I'm just saying, man.
How are you going to cure your
video
depression?
Video games is a cure, man.
How are you going to cure your depression by submerging yourself into a false reality?
Makes you happy.
That doesn't even make any sense.
Why do people do drugs?
That's literally like doing drugs. You're taking your
yeah.
brain somewhere that
except
is not
it's not
you.
Drugs.
So why can't you just be introspective and look within and think, like, what is going on inside of me? What is causing strife? What is causing issue? What is causing me stress? What is causing me depression? And once you can find the underlying reasons, you can try to begin to fix them. But if you're submerging yourself into a false reality on a daily basis, then you're never really processing your feelings. You're never really processing your thoughts. And I think that that's very, very dangerous, because one day you will wake up 20, 30 years down the line and you're going to be very unhappy with how you lived your life, because you never sat in quiet and thought, where am I going? What do I like? What do I don't like? Who do I like? Who
they
do
like
I don't
video
like?
Games.
You know, so you figure all those things by just having quiet and peace. Quiet and peace. And you can really go inside and dive into your own mind and think about what the hell is going on. What is your purpose
in
life?
You know, it sounds like you're saying that anybody who spends a lot of time on their hobby, right?
Sure.
Like making music, playing video games, is wasting their time.
Oh, I never said.
How do you feel about those musicians, man?
Well, I never said, you know, playing music is a waste of time. I said playing video games is a waste of time.
So what's the difference?
Well, the difference is that when you're making music, not only are you making a contribution to yourself, there's intricacy in notes, and that's great for your mental development. That also relieves stress. And also you're making beautiful music for other people. So you're sharing your gift to others. And on top of that, if you're smart and if you're resourceful, you can turn it into a business, you know? So
really?
Sure. You can. Anybody can. If you,
I wish I was writing this down. You're not seeing the irony as you're speaking, when the exact same thing could be done with video games.
Okay.
All right.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're learning as you're playing the game.
Mm-hmm.
You can get smarter.
Are you?
You can get smarter. By maybe not all, not all the time.
Okay.
But you can, you know, your reaction skills, you know, you might be a better driver if you play video games.
Bullshit.
You specifically might be a better driver if you played video games.
I'm a great driver.
You're a driver.
A great one,
too. I agree
too.
With that. But yeah, man, musicians and people who play video games, it's all the same, bro. How do you feel about people who go fishing, bro? It's all the same shit. That's a waste of time, too.
I think
everything is a waste of time.
Fishing sounds like a lovely thing. I don't fish, but it sounds lovely. But it's also a sport. And I think all sports are also a waste of time.
Hey, yo.
Yeah.
We're not going down this road.
Unless you play golf.
What?
In which case, it's probably a good idea.
Golf?
Sure.
What is so different about golf?
Well, let me tell you. One, less physical impact. Okay, which is a contributor to CTE, which we're all aware of the fact that, you know, that's an existing repercussion of being damaged and physically impacted throughout your life as, you know, playing football or, you know, playing soccer or whatever, basketball. So, yeah, I don't think you find that with golf or with fishing. So, yeah, if you want to have a great life, fish and play golf, you know, and don't play video games.
So
talk to girls. Go outside. Talk to people.
Sports,
say hello to your neighbors. Hi, hi. How are you?
Playing golf is the best option when that's the pussiest, most bullshit sport that you could have chosen out of all of them. That's insane.
They wear nice outfits too.
You just said to tell them to go get some pussy.
Listen,
I will tell anyone who plays golf to go get some pussy.
Here's the worst part: is the same guys that grow up to be sports fanatics, the same guys that you see at sports stadiums who are wearing jerseys with another man's last name on their back. Would you ever wear a man's last name on your back?
Absolutely not.
Me either. I would never wear another man's name on my back. That's insanity. First of all,
that's dick riding.
Exactly. And these guys are at these sports stadiums wearing men's names on their back, eating hot dogs, drinking beer. I mean, this is horrendous.
Oh, we're about to get backlash for
this.
And
you know what's worse? None of these guys, I assure you, none of these guys actually play sports. So they're not even a fan of sports. They're a fan of watching big, sweaty men touch each other while they wear their last name on their back. That's what they're a fan of. And that's concerning. And video game guys are the same thing. So what concerns me is, what are these kids going to grow up to be? It's concerning. You know,
God save the queen.
what do you mean? The queen is dead. She's dead.
All because of people like you.
What do you mean?
I don't fucking know.
She died of old age, I think. Or Epstein's family killed her. I don't know.
Oh,
but
shit.
Listen,
man.
The queen is dead. And you know, quite frankly, I don't care. And I know that sounds brash, it may sound insensitive, but here's the thing. You know, I didn't personally know her, and I also do not live in England, so I'm completely unaffected by the situation. I also don't follow the royal family, so I know nothing about them, really, essentially.
All right, I mean, I don't think anyone really cares, but this is just what the people want to know right now, man.
Sure.
They want to know about the colonialism and about the racism with Meghan and Harry.
Wait, did you say racism?
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure I'm aware of any racism.
No. What are you talking about? No, can you tell me that you weren't aware of anything going on in there?
But
so
can you tell me what you're talking about? What kind of racism are you speaking of?
So Meghan is half black.
She is? Is she related to Barack?
Stop.
Because she doesn't look black.
Why do you say that to everyone that's mixed?
Because I can't tell.
That's racist, bro.
No, because she doesn't look black. To me, she looks like a white woman who went to the beach and tanned. She doesn't look like a black person.
Well, I mean, she is super light skin. But when you compare that light skin with, you know, albino motherfuckers in the royal family, right?
Okay.
They're going to start talking shit.
So, I mean,
I have started talking shit.
I'm darker than her. Am I black?
No, you are not.
I'm 15% African, according to 23andMe.
But if you were married... Stop. Hey, I just caught that shit, bro.
I'm 15% black.
If you were married...
African, sorry.
If you were married to one of them white bitches, right? In the royal family.
Sure.
It don't matter what you are, bro. You're going to be black to them.
And
they
so
what? They're going to start treating you different, bro. The media, all the tabloids, they were just fucking with her, man. She was suicidal.
Well, then she
that
should
shit was crazy.
She should probably kill herself then if she feels that way.
No, she chose to leave. Hey, well, stop it.
Listen, again, I'm not quite sure I'm aware of any racism that's been public or transparent concerning
Mrs. You are aware
Mrs.
now. I just told you.
Mrs. Markle, okay? The only thing I can personally assess from the situation that you have presented me and from vaguely from what I've read and know about is that Meghan Markle is one of the most fortunate and lucky women on planet Earth. She so happens to be black. She's a black woman, right?
That's
and
right.
She married a white royal prince.
All right.
Where exactly does racism exist in this scenario?
I already told you 5 minutes
so
ago.
So what you're telling me is that she's a black woman and she married a literal white prince from England.
Yes.
And racism is real.
Yes. Because nobody wanted it to happen. But Prince Harry was like, fuck y'all. He gonna smash her.
Listen,
and that's that.
If the royal family, which I don't know them, but I'm only hypothesizing here. I'm just trying to figure out what's really happening. I'm trying to get to the bottom of all this. But if the royal family were truly racist and objected to their marriage of, you know, what's his name? Prince Harry?
Prince Harry.
Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, I'm sure they would have made her disappear. And I'm sure they have the resources to do so. I mean, you know, they could...
You're forgetting that Harry still has power.
Of what?
He's not going to let that shit happen.
What do you mean?
He's part of the royal family. He has power. Not as much power as the rest of them, but I mean, he's not going to allow that shit to happen. Come on now.
I don't know. All
and
I'm saying is
2022, bro. It's not like back in the day when they got rid of their slow cousins. This is 20, man.
What are you talking about?
You can research that on your own. I don't even want to fucking talk about it.
Well,
but I mean, yeah, man. They can't just get rid of someone nowadays.
I feel like they could have if they were truly racist, they probably would have done away. They would have killed her. But instead, this woman seems to continue to victimize herself, even though she's literal royalty and immensely wealthy, by the way. So it sounds to me like she's trying to publicly shame, publicly defame, publicly extort the royal family. It's just awful what she's doing.
I mean, I would too if I got cut off and they had to move to California. Well, they chose to move to California.
Right. They got cut off.
They chose.
They chose to?
Yeah.
They got and then they got cut off, right? They have no more money coming in, right, from that.
Yeah,
okay,
well, they got cut off and then they moved.
Did you know that Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have a charitable entity called Archwell Foundation? Have you heard of this?
You know a lot about this family.
Well.
No, I haven't heard of that. What is that?
I have photographic memory, okay? Sometimes I walk in down the city and, you know, there's a boy in the corner with a newspaper stand and I'll just look at it and I'll memorize everything that's on the paper. I don't even have to buy it.
That's impressive.
Which is unethical. I shouldn't do that.
That's impressive.
But
I hope they believe you.
Anyway, they have this charitable foundation that they founded called Archibald Foundation. And it so happens to be registered in the state of Delaware. So why do you think that is?
I don't know. They're trying to avoid something, right?
Right. Well, Delaware allows 95% of earnings to go to expenses, whatever that means. And whereas California only allows 60% for expenses for charities. So if both Prince Harry and Meghan Markle currently reside in California, why is it that their charity organization is registered thousands of miles away?
Well, think about it like this. If dude, they were living in Delaware,
come on, bro.
Would they start that same charity in Delaware or California?
Well, you should probably start it where you reside. Let's start there.
Nah, you start it where you profit.
It's a non-profit organization.
I don't fucking care, bro.
It's a charity.
Come on, man.
It's
you know those non-profits are not non-profit. That's bullshit.
Yeah,
man.
But these people are very wealthy. They're very wealthy, well-to-do, privileged people. She's a privileged black woman.
And that's,
a privileged,
that's how you stay privileged.
She's a privileged black woman, and he's a privileged redheaded man. And these people scare me. This royal couple has... What are you laughing at?
Just the way you said that. He's a privileged redheaded man.
Sorry. I don't mean to be that descript. I apologize. But
hilarious.
These people scare me. I mean, this royal couple has multiple attorneys advising them and how to get away with committing fraud. I mean, Prince Andrew got away with touching little girls, right?
I don't know much about that.
Yeah, I hope not.
But I'm not speaking on that, bro.
And what did Queen Elizabeth do at the time?
I don't know.
She murdered Epstein.
Oh, shit.
Right. She murdered Epstein. I'm even scared to say her name. And, and I've heard, and I'm not sure if this is true.
Oh, shit.
So don't take this at face value. But I've heard that if you say her name three times in front of a mirror, she appears.
That is not true.
Queen Elizabeth. Queen Elizabeth. Queen Elizabeth.
Hey, man. But anyways, I want to talk about something more important, you know, more serious. Because fuck the queen.
What?
9/11.
Okay, yeah.
9/11 just passed over the weekend. It's been 21 years. 21 years since the anniversary of Jay-Z dropping The Blueprint.
What?
And it was just an amazing album.
What are you
10
saying?
Out of 10.
Wait, what?
What's up?
What do you mean?
What do you mean? What do you mean?
What do you mean?
Well, Jay-Z dropped The Blueprint.
9/11?
2001. September 11th. You
Is that
remember?
Really what happened?
This man sold nearly 500K.
Oh, I've got muffin all over myself, but...
He sold nearly 500K.
Listen.
Insane. In 2001?
9/11 was a horrible... 9/11 was a horrible tragedy where many men, women...
How is Jay-Z making all those sales a tragedy?
9/11 was a horrible tragedy where many men, women, and children tragically died due... to an inside job orchestrated by the government to infiltrate Iraq, okay?
All right.
Okay? And to strip them of their resources and assassinate their leader, Saddam Hussein. That's exactly what happened on 9/11. Weapons of mass destruction, terror, 9/11, 9/11. That's all I heard. I still remember I was 11 years old, and that's all I heard for months. Terror, yeah. Terrorism, they're going to blow up your school. We have to go to Iraq and take all their oil. Yeah, and murder Saddam Hussein publicly so you can see that we murdered him. We're good people. That's imperialism. That's horrible. You know, what they did was horrible. I was not aware of the fact that Jay-Z dropped an album that day. But, you know, I'm also not surprised because he's also, you know, I'm sure part of these very strange organizations. He's too powerful. He's too powerful. And that's why he's the kind of guy that will drop an album on 9/11. He's an evil gentleman, I'm sure.
That will drop an album on... It happened in 2001. It happened in 2001.
Unless Jay-Z is an evil
You're
man.
You're saying he predicted 9/11?
He probably knew it was going to happen. He's probably friends with all the Bush family and the Clintons. You know, and here's the thing, is he's a really evil guy. Unless he'll hire me to shoot his music video, then he's a wonderful man. But if he's not, then he's a very, very evil man.
Hey, all I'm saying is I was walking out that CD store at 5 years old with his album in my hand, bro. So that was my day, bro. You know, following years of racism.
But how are
you to Muslims
so, like, unaffected? Yeah, like, exactly what I'm going to say. Like, you know, I remember... people equated terrorism to Arabs, Muslims, just generally speaking, just it was horrible. Like, if you were Muslim or if you're Middle Eastern or anywhere even near that region, if you kind of just even look at like you're a fucking Greek or some shit like that, you were considered, or even a fucking Indian person, you know, they were considered a terrorist and people were afraid
of
these people.
It's true, bro. I tried traveling to Canada like in 2004.
Yeah.
Bro.
By plane?
By plane.
Do you have a box cutter on you?
It was not a good time, man. Okay. And I was too young at the time, too. I didn't even understand why they were profiling my mom and shit. It was fucking bad, bro.
Is your mother Muslim?
Yes, obviously.
Okay.
So am I.
Well.
Yeah, dude, it's bad.
I don't know.
Man.
I mean, because I don't know. Only my dad was Muslim. My dad was Muslim. My mom was. She's still alive. My dad was Muslim and my mom is Catholic. That's why I ask. I don't know what if your mother, man.
And it's like, they always say like, never forget, right?
Yeah.
And they're always like, slavery happened a long time ago. You can forget about that.
Yeah.
slavery was a long time ago, man. You just forget about it. Reparations. Come on. We put you in movies now.
That's
true.
Yeah, Black Panther now?
Like, y'all niggas,
think
man.
Think about
Shit.
It. Yeah, you're right. Think about it.
Fuck y'all niggas, bro.
Think about it. They're right, though. Okay, think about this. Who's the most famous artist in the world? Most successful, most money, probably.
Kanye,
right? Race is he?
Or Jay-Z.
What race is he?
He is African American.
He's black, okay? Hold on. No, what
that's
about
a little bit racist the way
what
you
about
said
women?
It.
I've heard through the grapevine that there's a woman who just married into a royal family. What race is she? Meghan Markle?
White.
She's black. She's black.
She's half black.
Okay. Who's the most famous comedian? And who earns the most money? I know. Dave Chappelle, and he's black.
Dave Chappelle, yeah.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, who was the president 2 presidents ago? Barack Obama. And he's yes, what sir. Now? Is he black? He's black.
He is white.
He could be. We never saw the birth certificate, okay?
We did see the birth certificate, motherfucker.
Yeah, and it said he was born in Kenya.
Stop,
and he's Muslim.
Bro. Oh my God.
All I'm saying is that, you know, you're right. We can forget because, you know, blacks and have had so many accomplishments, you know. I mean, you have Jordan Peele out here making horrible movies, you know, and people love them, even though they're bad. They're pretty bad.
They're pretty good.
I've never seen any good movie that he's made, but I haven't seen the last one that
you
watched.
I've seen all of them.
What's the last one that he made, the UFO one?
I don't even fucking remember the name of it, bro.
That's how
forgettable. It was pretty good, though. That's pretty good, though. I'm not going to lie.
That's how forgettable that film was. That you don't even remember the title of the movie. It's pretty sad.
I'm going to remember in like 2 minutes,
it's
bro.
A telltale sign.
I remember in like 2 minutes.
It's not a great film. I'm sure.
Fuck, what was the name of it?
It doesn't matter because it probably wasn't good. Stop thinking so hard. It wasn't
Dude,
that good.
It's killing my brain right now.
It wasn't that good. Another person, another notable black person, vice president right now. What's her name? Kamala Harris. She's black.
She's white.
Blackish. We'll say blackish for her.
She's something.
Blackish. Yeah.
She's in there.
Right. So there's been amazing stride, amazing resolve with
the
black and white conflict.
The movie is called Nope. I remember. Yeah, Jordan Peele.
Horrible title.
It's a good title.
It's a bad title.
It's a forgettable title.
It's a very forgettable
title.
It's not a good title. And he's not a. I'm not saying he's a bad. He's a good director. He's just. I don't like the fact that he steals. He's a steals.
He gets inspiration from different places.
No. He's like the
and he creates his own art with it.
No.
He's like a sampler in music.
No, he's like
samples.
No, he's like more like Christopher Columbus, where he came and stole
Shit.
Things from people, and then he pretended like it was his.
And then he made it better.
No, what happened is what I'm referring to is the movie Get Out. Is that what it's called? Get Out.
Yeah.
Okay. I remember when that film was released. I think it was like a couple years ago, right? Get Out was a couple years ago.
Yeah, I think it was like 2017,
right. 2016. During that time, I still believed in journalism for whatever reason. I wasn't jaded yet. And so I still believed in, you know, critic reviews and things of that nature. I still believed in Rotten Tomatoes. So I remember Get Out was released.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
Rotten
I know,
Tomatoes.
Right? So anyhow, so Get Out was released, and I remember looking at Rotten Tomatoes, and I was like, oh my God, I want to say it had 100%. For critic reviews. And I was
tripping.
Yeah, that's a little bit too much.
A little bit too much. So you got 100%.
75.
Right now?
No, I meant like...
You would give it 75.
I'd give it like 75.
Well, okay. Well, at the time, I had 100%. So for me, I was like, this has to be the best movie ever made. So I was very excited. I went to the movie theater. I watched it, and I was like, this is trash. First of all, it's trash. Second of all, it's not trash. It's a ripoff off the novel, the book, Stepford Wives, which was later adapted into a film in 2005. And it was basically the same premise. And so, you know, Jordan Peele stole that and then took it for his own. And then the worst part is that all the critics, I'm sure the film critics knew this, but they couldn't say anything because he was black. And that's reverse racism.
Guess why?
Because he's black.
Guess why?
Because he's black?
Because for years, white people have been stealing from our culture.
That is true.
They've been stealing ideas. They steal music.
You're right.
They steal everything.
Look at Eminem. He's made a whole career.
So guess
of black
what?
Culture. You're right.
We stealing that shit back, man. Fuck it.
I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Let's do it, man.
I'm good with that. But I will say, though, that I wish that one film critic would have stood up and said, hey, he stole that. That's plagiarism. Are these people, the state of the folks that wrote Stepford Wives, are they getting royalties for this? Are they getting paid for this? The family of the descendants of this man who wrote this movie, wrote this film, the guys who originally produced and directed it, are they getting royalties for this now? I'm sure they're not. That's the worst part.
Nah, fuck them.
Why?
They don't deserve royalties.
Why not?
Because they probably stole that shit from somewhere else.
I don't think so.
Bro, how often does shit just get stolen or just reproduced in different ways? Come on, man.
And I'm sure it happens a lot. But the thing is that it's very concerning. It's very bothersome when there's something that's applauded and it's so blatantly stolen. You know, it's how would you give it 100% in Rotten Tomato reviews by all these film critics pretending when they know, because they're film critics. I mean, I'm sure they're film buffs and that this film was stolen. And then turned into a black film. It's insane. It's insane and it's upsetting. And that's all I have to say about that.
All right, man. Since you're so invested.
Sure.
On what my people are doing.
You mean my people? I'm 15%.
Stop it. 15% what?
African. Congan. Congo. From Congo.
You're from Mexico.
I'm not from Mexico.
And the Middle East. I was born
in Fountain Valley, California.
You're from Mexico and the Middle East. But let me ask you this.
Where's the Middle East, by the way?
In the Middle East.
And it's neighbors which place?
I don't fucking
Africa.
Care, bro. All right. You know what else neighbors Africa?
What?
The fucking ocean.
Okay, and what else?
Are you from the ocean?
I'm not Laotian, no. I'm Mexican Middle Eastern.
I'll tell you what is in the ocean, though.
What?
The Little Mermaid. And since you're so invested into what black people are doing...
Sure.
How do you feel about this new black Little Mermaid?
Wait.
I'm feeling the negative energy coming out of you right now.
So you're telling me that there's a new... Little Mermaid movie. What was wrong with the first one?
Live action Little Mermaid.
Okay. I hate these, by the way. I hate all these live action Disney movies they're doing. They're
Some
all trash.
Them,
Which one was good?
I think one was good? I'll tell you, The Jungle Book was pretty good.
The Jungle Book was pretty good.
You actually watched that?
Yes, it was good.
It was pretty good. The rest of them are trash.
I watched both of them. I watched the Warner Brothers one and I watched the Disney one. They were both good. I liked them both. But I was the only one they got right. All the other ones were trash.
I never saw the other ones.
You know what's interesting about the Jungle Boy, whatever it's called? Jungle Book?
What do you mean Jungle Boy?
Jungle Book?
Hey, watch who you're calling Jungle Boy. You better chill with that
But
shit.
You know what's interesting about the Jungle Boy? Jungle Book? What if they would have done this? What if they would say, you know what? We're going to change the Jungle Boy. And he's not going to be like this Polynesian looking brown kid. Like the original version of him was. You know, he's actually going to have to be white. He's having to be white. Because, you know, there's been a lot of black people on movies. Even the Asians are getting their movies and things like that. It's like everyone's getting their movies. What about the whites? And so what if they put a white in the Jungle Boy? You'd be like, wait a minute.
Bro, I'm about to blow your whole fucking mind right now.
No, no, but you would have been
like, there was a live action Tarzan, and the motherfucker was white.
Was this the 90s?
The motherfucker was white,
was
bro.
But
this is like not even 10 years ago, dog.
I don't believe you. I need proof.
Keep scratching your head.
I need to see the citation for all this.
Dog, I'm telling you it exists, bro. It exists. He's white.
Okay, and that's fine. See, here's the thing.
Come on, man.
No, here's the thing. No, here's the thing. Humans are human. That's it. So it doesn't matter if you're black.
How do you feel specifically about the Little Mermaid, though?
I think that the Little Mermaid should look like what the cartoon looked like. That's what I feel. Just like the Jungle Book. I feel like the Jungle Book should try to look as close to the cartoon as possible. You know? That's how I feel about it. Just like if they redid Snow White, I hope she's not black because she was fucking
Damn.
Snow White. It's the truth.
No, that's true. That doesn't make any fucking sense.
And,
yeah,
and, it's like, and it would be really weird if the little midget guys, if they were really tall, you know, like Asian and black and Mexican guys hanging out with her.
Damn. So you're saying that the seven dwarfs can't be different races?
No, they were all white in the movie. Did you see
that's just one
any
movie,
racial
bro.
Like ambiguity in this film? They were all white.
Do you think Disney...
It's literally called Snow White.
Do you think Disney created that? He just copied that shit from somewhere else. All those cartoons are copied
from
somewhere else.
It doesn't matter. It's authenticity. They're having the same problem with Lord of the Rings. They have like a TV series with Lord of the Rings, and they're making all these characters different races. Like, why are we doing this?
It's not that bad.
Listen.
It's not that bad. It's not as bad as what people say. It's just a lot of bad writing going on.
No. There's a lot of places where they can employ minorities and they don't. A lot of places. They decide to do them in these big budget things.
Yes.
That they know they're going to get profit from. Because people are going to look past all this PC bullshit and be like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going to watch it anyway because I'm a fan. But it's like, why don't they put like minority people in regular stuff? Like, you know, maybe why don't you put them in fucking... I don't know, like those sitcom shows. Why don't you make the main character a fucking Asian guy or Mexican guy? They won't because that's a recurring show. It's not has to have a big name behind it, and it's not going to sell as well. It's going to get canceled.
You've never seen Fresh Off the Boat?
I don't know. I've not seen it, no.
It is an Asian family sitcom.
Is it still going on?
Maybe.
Or did it get canceled? Because I'm pretty sure I heard it got canceled.
So you never heard of it, but you heard it got canceled?
I know certain things.
What the fuck is wrong?
I know it got canceled. That's all I do know. And let me tell you why.
There's a lot of black sitcoms, bro. What are you talking about? My Wife and Kids, fucking Everybody Hates Chris, bro. There's like a bunch of them.
And they're all canceled. And let me tell you why.
Everybody Hates
Chris, and it's canceled.
Chris.
And let me tell you why.
It went on for a bunch of seasons, though.
Yeah, but it got canceled. Bernie Mac, he's dead. He also got canceled.
It wasn't... Bro, Bernie Mac has his own show called The Bernie Mac Show.
Yeah, in the coffin, Bernie Mac. That's what he has now. He's dead. But the point is that what I'm trying to say is the reason why these people put all these fucking
so
white
bad.
People on these shows is because the majority of the United States is fucking white people. So, you know, when you're a white person living in Minnesota, like, you turn on the TV, you want to see people that look like your fucking family and friends. You know what I mean? And that's why they do that, because it brings in more revenue. But now big, you know, companies like Disney are saying like, no, like, you know, let's not do that. Let's put in the blacks. Let's put in the Mexicans. Let's put in the Asians. Let's put in everybody. Let's make it all inclusive, which is actually great. You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. You win. He wins. You're right. You're right.
Somehow I feel like you don't believe that.
No, I do. It's actually, you know what? It's funny. It's kind of funny because there's a guy right now in Wisconsin turning on his TV going like, God damn it. Like another goddamn Mexican in here or like goddamn black. And that's kind of funny.
Yeah, fuck them.
I still think that there should be authenticity in these films. And so if in this book it specifically said they were white, let them be white. If it said that they're going to be black, let them be black. I think leave it at that, and that's it. You know, what's the big fucking deal? Be authentic. Everyone should be authentic, and so should stories.
Don't you, as a director, want to be able to create your own story? Don't you have your own vision?
Yeah, but I also want Huckleberry Finn to be its original version and say like the N-word 70 times.
Oh shit!
But it got removed. That's unauthentic. I want the
authentic version.
I'm sorry?
There's a movie for that?
No, the book, Huckleberry Finn, it originally had like the N-word like maybe 70 or 100 times like in the book. Now
You're saying it got removed?
They made a new version where they removed the N-word.
No way.
Yes. Yeah. I want the real Huckleberry Finn. I want the real racism.
No, that's way better.
What do you mean?
That's way better, man. We never read that in school. I know other classes did.
Yeah.
But not mine. We read a different book that also had the N-word in it a bunch of times.
Which one?
I don't remember what it was called. But I do remember my teacher being a little bit too enthusiastic with it. And that shit pissed me off, bro. That shit pissed me off, bro. I'm just like, dude, I'm like 11 years old. I don't really understand
a whole
bunch of
shit. Can you repeat
shit.
How she would say it? Like with a little gusto? Like how would she say it?
It's almost like with a little smirk, you know? Like she's excited that she gets to say it.
She probably is.
And I'm the only black kid in the class, bro. It was in fucking Huntington Beach. So I'm just sitting there pissed off and everyone's like... Like every time,
yeah.
It's like, bro, I'm about to go up there and smack the shit out this bitch, bro.
Right.
That's crazy.
And that's.
But the book itself.
Yeah.
They shouldn't censor it. That doesn't make any sense.
They shouldn't censor anything. They should keep everything authentic. Leave it as it is.
Censor the teacher's mouth with my fucking fist, though, bro.
That's terrible. No, but because you know what that is? That's erasing history. That's erasing history. And it just like
history. That shit is fiction, bro.
What?
That shit's fiction.
Yeah, but it's still erasing like a part of history where, you know, you would read that and you'd be shocked now because you'd be like, this is insane that this was published and was deemed normal at the time.
Yeah.
Which, you know, I think that should be, people should still publish books in that way.
People ban books like
pieces.
That.
Yeah, but they shouldn't.
They ban like 1984 too in like some states. It's kind of crazy.
That's concerning.
And To Kill a Mockingbird. I don't know why all these books are getting banned. It's kind of crazy.
I read when I was a kid Where the Red Ferns Grow. Do you remember that one?
Was that like some gay shit? Or?
No.
I don't know, man. No,
it was a small white boy who was from the countryside, and he had these two bloodhounds. And he would go hunting. They were his best friends, and he saved up money to buy the hounds. And, you know, one ended up tragically dying at the end. And it was very sad. Very, very
spoiler
sad.
Alert,
you should watch
bro,
it.
What the fuck?
Well, you weren't going to read it anyway.
I wasn't going
to. I recommend things to you all the time.
I wasn't really paying attention.
Yeah,
to
I bet you weren't. And they probably aren't either, so we're going to call it already. But, you know, thanks for hanging out with us again. We really appreciate it. If you did stick around to the very end, it really does mean a lot to us. And if you're still here and you haven't subscribed, please do so. Leave us a comment below, whether it's love or hate. We love to hear all of it. And, I don't know. Follow us on Instagram. You can follow me at Chris Camera Guy on Instagram. And Ollie's is
BlackFro_Ollie. Make sure to follow. Make sure to subscribe to this channel, the Pod Bros. Make sure to subscribe to our Clips channel, the Pod Bros Clips.
Yeah, we
have it in the description below.
Yeah, we have a Clips channel. And it's we haven't really, I guess, promoted the fact that we have it, but it's there, and you know we'll have a link to it. So subscribe to it; it helps. You know, if you want to watch it in shorter form. But anyway,
That's
have a good
true.
Day, guys.
Peace out, motherfuckers.